So obviously you have a lot of great issues that you both talked about, and it's got me motivated, and I'm sure it's got a lot of the students motivated as well. So as students and as prospective business people coming out into the workforce in a few months, some of us, what can we do to get involved, and even as leaders, both men and women? I know I'm pretty interested in knowing what I can do to give back as an ambassador, you say, for agriculture. So how could we get involved in what areas, I guess?
First of all, never have your time schedule so full that you lose the time to volunteer. You can be anything you want as a volunteer. You can volunteer in any industry. You can volunteer for most jobs. You learn so much as a volunteer, and I know Betty Jean and I have done hundreds and hundreds of hours of volunteer. It's why we are where we are, and it gives us a broad scope of knowledge. That's the number one thing you can do when you stop being a student. Because all of a sudden you have all this time, and then you realize, oh, maybe I wasn't as busy as I thought as a student. I've talked to a number of students. They thought, gee, this 9-to-5 stuff's pretty tough. You know, this work stuff is pretty hard. Because, you know, you're in charge of your own time now. Yes, you're overloaded, and you're pulling all-nighters to do your exams and stuff. I have kids that do that, too. But when you get into the workforce, you're dead tired at the end of the day because your brain is exhausted and you've got routine. But don't give up your zest and passion to volunteer. Volunteer with OAFE, please. Volunteer with OAFE. We could use all the volunteers we can get. Go onto the agricultural site and find out Canadian Federation of Agriculture and look at what the different provinces offer in terms of their associations. You know, I got 132 acronyms pinned up on my little bulletin board. They're all associations and they all do something very worthwhile in agriculture. How many do you know? Challenge yourself to find out about these organizations and call them up. And there may be some stunned silence at the other end of the line saying, did you say you want to volunteer? but we'll get over that stunned stuff and we'll say yes, you know, you can volunteer with our organizations. So I would recommend that as number one of what you can do.
Yeah, it's got to be volunteerism. I'll bet your mom never got a dime for any hours she spent at the Farm Women's Network and was lucky to get her expenses covered. And eventually you will get to a position like mine where I get my expenses covered. They give me a per diem, which I in turn pay someone else to clean my house and cook and run the juice apple business. But the volunteerism works. We need all sorts of help at the Royal Winter Fair, at your local, every county in this province has a Federation of Agriculture. And unfortunately, it's peopled by volunteers of my generation, because the young people, like my son, besides his demands of the farm, has a young family to raise. So volunteers of your generation are very hard to come by. Just because of the responsibilities you have out in your life right now.